Trials are going to be over. The persecution is going to be over. The temptations are going to be over. And Jesus tells us in St. John the 14th chapter, let not your hearts be troubled, that you believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions, and if it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also. You know, during the dark days of World War II, President Roosevelt ordered General MacArthur to leave the Philippines and proceed to Australia to take command of the army, the armies in the Far East there. He didn't want to go. He wanted to stay with his troops, but he had to go. He had to leave under presidential order. When he arrived in the Philippines, in Australia, the news media asked him for a comment. He said, President of the United States ordered me to leave Philippines and proceed to Australia to take command of the Allied forces in this part of the Pacific. And as I understand, the main purpose being the liberation of the Philippine Islands. He said, I came through and I shall return. And that became the rallying cry in World War II. I shall return. I shall return. You know, they printed these words on chewing gum wrappers. They dropped leaflets from airplanes over the Philippine Islands to keep the courage alive in the hearts of the Filipino people during the Japanese occupation. General MacArthur said, I shall return. General MacArthur kept his word. He did return. The Philippines were liberated. And the greater than General MacArthur, hallelujah, left his band of followers there on the Mount of Olives. But I shall return. I'm going away. I'm going away. I'm going to prepare a place for you, but I shall return. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Somewhere in this universe, there's a city that covers 2.25 million square miles. Hallelujah. It's got walls of pure jasper, 6,000 miles around these walls. These walls are around 100 yards high. These walls are seated on 12 foundations. And each one of them a precious stone. Garnish all manner precious stone. These walls have 12 huge gates. Each one of them is a pure pearl. Hallelujah. The streets of this city are pure gold, like in the transparent glass. Make 21 carat look like throwaway trash. And John said the city itself is pure gold. Glory to God. Amen. Some of you look happy and some of you frown. Everybody smile at me that. I don't ever expect to have a fine mansion down here in this world. It don't matter because I'm not going to be here much longer. My wife and I's got a 2-bedroom wood frame house in the Blue Ridge Mountains of North Carolina. But I've got a house in the New Jerusalem. The walls are made out of gold. The roof is made out of gold. Hallelujah. The floor is made out of gold. The door knobs are made out of gold. And there's never going to be a rent collector knocking on the door. And there's never going to be a mortgage payment notice in the mailbox because Jesus paid the price in full when he hung on that old red cross 2,000 years ago. Hallelujah. I'm an heir of God and I'm a joint heir of Jesus Christ. And I've got a title of aid. Hallelujah. To mention the New Jerusalem. Glory to God. Hallelujah. 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 Now just think about it. Just imagine if your house that you live in was pure gold. And the street in front of your house was pure gold. Just think about it. Blows your mind, don't it?
Yeah.
But it's going to be like that in the next life. And we serve God.
Yes.
Amen. And the walls out around the city a solid jasper.
Uh-huh.
And John said we won't need any sunlight, moonlight, or candlelight there, because the glory of God and the glory of the Lamb will